Hello tipsters and tricksters, welcome back to my channel and welcome to another Vintage Tips and Tricks video.
What have you got if you haven't got love?
Today, I'm going to be honest, I'm doing kind of a lazy video. I think you might actually enjoy the topic, but I'm doing the topic because I was supposed to do a much more involved video that involved me going shopping and making things and doing an activity, and So instead I decided to do my 5 tips for dressing in the masculine vintage style. So when I talk about the masculine vintage style, I mean the style exuded by icons such as Katherine Hepburn, Marlene Dietrich, even Audrey Hepburn and Grace Kelly were known to don this masculine style, as well as many other a movie star of the golden era of Hollywood. They would often dabble in the more kind of masculine outfits offset, and when they weren't walking the red carpet, there was lots of kind of comfortable clothing that had more of a masculine vibe, particularly post-World War II. So today I thought I would talk about how you can start incorporating that into your wardrobe, because I don't know about you guys, but I love dressing in the masculine style because it is comfy. When I dress in a masculine style, I don't wear any of my normal structural undergarments. No corsets, no waspies, nothing like that. Like even today I have high-waisted capris on, but I'm just wearing a belt. Often I'll be wearing my Catherine slacks or a pair of 40s, like true vintage slacks, and just wearing like normal cotton undies and a bra. And the comfort is highly welcome. So the main thing about this vibe, this style, is actually like the comfort of men's clothing. So often, particularly people like Katherine Hepburn, would wear this kind of slouchy, comfy version of the outfit. I mean, even Greta Garbo was known for having these kind of like open, oversized men's style white shirts and men's style slacks. You can even go into vintage stores or thrift stores and find men's clothing in smaller sizes and wear that instead. I know there's plenty of girls in the vintage community who wear men's slacks, but also like women's slacks. 80s business slacks pass as 40s slacks really, really well. How many times do I want to say the word slacks? It is really, really easy to get hold of clothing that will pass for this style because men's clothing hasn't really changed in a really, really long time. So trawling thrift stores for that style, and also it came back in the 80s, so finding shirts and trousers in the women's section of thrift and vintage stores is going to be a real winner in terms of getting this kind of vibe going in your outfit. The shirt I'm wearing today is just a normal white shirt that I actually wear for my job when I do like corporate work. So it's not even like a vintage cut or anything. It is a stock standard white shirt that you can get from any high street store, from any thrift shop, like on eBay. Like they're really affordable and they're an absolute staple. And they're actually something I would recommend someone grab. It's probably already in your wardrobe, but it's a really good like beginner vintage piece because the plain white shirt is kind of every era, you know what I mean? Sometimes things like the collar and stuff will change slightly depending on the era, but it's not going to be something that is really obvious. Like people aren't really going to look at your outfit and go like, that white shirt has a 40s collar, not a 30s collar. Like it's just probably not going to happen. So it's a really good staple to have in your wardrobe anyway, but it is a definite staple of this more masculine style. The other thing to look for, as I've said, is high-waisted pleated trousers. A wide-legged one is more of a 40s look, but the slightly tapered leg that you still see in business slacks today was also very popular, and you're going to be very true to the era and don't have to go out and get true vintage slacks, because true vintage 40s slacks are actually hard to come by and tend to be very expensive. So you can cheat that really, really easily. For shoes, a good flat, so things like boat shoes, loafers, plimsolls, espadrilles, or even a pair of ballet flats if you've just got them lying around and you want to just wear what you've already got in your wardrobe. And even like the two-tone, wait, I have them here. Or even like saddle shoes. You've got so many options, guys. A flat, comfortable shoe is definitely something you can wear for a very authentic vintage style, but be comfortable and go for that more masculine vibe. And you know what? Sometimes I feel like wearing more masculine clothing, but then doing your hair vintage and having like vintage makeup is actually like very, very feminine in a weird way. It's like the juxtaposition of the masculine clothing with the feminine hair and makeup. for me, feels really like strong, powerful feminine, which I really love. There are so many influencers on Instagram that really rock this style. I think I'll put a few of them up here because some of them are just so, so cool and really pull off this masculine vibe very, very well, particularly in things like plus fours or like newsboy caps and the way that they tie their scarves. Some of them even wear proper men's silk ties from the 30s and 40s, and it just looks so incredibly cool. And that's another thing that you can go for to try and get this style up and going. If you've just got a pair of pretty plain modern business slacks and a shirt, you could make it look more vintage by wearing things like the newsboy cap or the baker boy cap. You could wear a tie, and again, it doesn't have to be a vintage one. You could get one from the op shop as long as it's got the right kind of shape to it. Like, just remember, the 40s tended to have that much wider tie. Wearing suspenders, like men's braces, you know, things like that are really gonna give you the vibe. Argyle socks, stuff like that. So if you're wanting to go for this vibe and you don't want to spend a lot of money, sometimes accessories are going to be a really, really helpful friend. And if you want to give it that more kind of feminine spin, you'll see that people like Elizabeth Taylor and Grace Kelly went really masculine with the outfit, but then they did things like tie a scarf around their neck or even around their waist. If you're feeling like maybe the outfit for you is a little too masculine, you can balance it up again with accessories. So for example, like, I've got a white shirt and a pair of capris on, but then I've gone with a necktie, a little brooch, and a set of earrings and some red lippy, and it kind of really vamps it up a bit. Whereas if I was just wearing this stuff and I hadn't kind of got all glam and added the accessories, it would look like a pretty stock standard plain outfit and wouldn't really even look vintage. A lot of the time, and this is true of a lot of vintage outfits, a lot of the time it is about the accessories. The other thing I like about this style, if you look at people like Greta Garbo and Katherine Hepburn, is that they actually went much more natural with their hair and makeup. So it is a really low maintenance vintage look. You can just put your hair in pin curls, but not really spend the time brushing it out a lot. Just like comb through it, let the curls do their thing, and maybe pin one side back with a bobby pin, and you're pretty much set to go. Or if you've got a bob, like a Greta Garbo look, half the time she looked like she had bed hair and she just stuck a hat on. Like, she rocked that bedhead look as far as it could go. And I mean, maybe she spent a long time making that hair look tousled. Or maybe, as per her reputation, she just got laid and then went out on the town. Who knows? But it worked for her. So guys, it's a pretty short and sweet one, but I thought I would have a chat about that because not a lot of people talk about the like masculine vintage style on YouTube. A lot of people are into that more kind of princessy Disney bounding vibe, which is very cool in itself, but it's nice to have options. And I think there's a lot of different niches out there, or like sub niches in the vintage style community, and this one was an interesting one to chat about. Let me know in the comments how you like to incorporate more of a masculine vibe into your style. I'd love to hear how you go about it. I probably will get some tips myself, because as I always say, you guys teach me just as much as I teach you. But yeah, that's the video, guys. I hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and comment down below. Let me know what you thought of the video and any tips for future videos. Come and follow me on my Instagram. Check out my Patreon. It is linked down below for more vintage tips and tricks. We have a monthly follow-along video. The last two was making a hair corsage, and then the next one in July was making pom-pom boudoir slippers, so making our own shoe clips to pop on a pair of heels to give them that, like, slinky 1940s boudoir slipper feel. And there's plenty of other perks along the way over on Patreon as well, so do go and check it out. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video. Bye.